Hey there, YouTubers. Umbreon Liberator here, bringing you part 2 of my Danganronpa 2 playthrough. So, let's introduce ourselves to the rest of the student people. A little bit different. I go the other way around. I don't think it should matter though. Pretty sure some people are at the airport. This is an airport, right? So those things over there must be airplanes? Couldn't we use those planes to escape this island? Nah, that's impossible. If they were damaged, I could fix them. But it looks like these planes are just for show. Just for show.
Man.
The edges have been completely removed. Nothing I could do about that. Completely removed? Whoever brought us to this island must have also done that. Right? The same person who's controlling that stuffed animal, Uzami. But why did they bring us to this island in the first place? And how did they do it? The more I think about it, the less sense it makes.
That's right!
Oh yeah, that reminds me, you and me haven't been introduced yet, right?
Name's Kazuichi Soda. I'm the ultimate mechanic. Nice to meet ya.
Yeah, it's pretty strange, but I think it's an acceptable level of strange, you know? Huh?
I mean,
well, think about it. It's not like we're being forced to do something dangerous or something. Or anything. I was mentioning the safety precautions for this school trip. Remember the school trip guidelines written in the e-handbook? Together to attain hope fragments, littering this island and its coexist with this island's bountiful nature and futile prosperity. The lead teacher cannot directly interfere with the students. An exception to this rule is made if any students violate the rule. Okay.
For now,
it looks like we're being kept safe, so why wouldn't this be like any other school trip? There's nothing dangerous on this island, but these peaceful and relaxing days, nourishing our place to keep us, to help us through that. Are you saying you believe that what that thing told us? She forced us to come here, you know.
But
don't be such a pessimist. You should look at this situation with a bit more hope, you know. Optimism is essential for people to live satisfying lives.
That's right!
Well, I guess it's okay if we just enjoy our vacation and see how this whole thing plays out, right? You stare closely at that strange-looking bunny girl. She might start looking pretty cute. I'm actually jealous of how carefree he's being right now. Right there, if you value your life, do not come any closer. Huh?
Fine.
I said stay back. Oh, very well. I shall accept that courage of yours. What's this guy talking about? Would you like to know my name? Others may see your courage as reckless. However, I welcome it.
Listen well!
In honor of your courage, I shall reveal to you my name. May you never forget it as long as you live.
You may call me
Gundam
Tanaka. Remember it well, for it is the name that will one day rule this world.
Can't not help myself with that. Plus the fact that I accidentally talked over something. Stuff happens. Ultimate breeder. Rule this world? He's kidding, right?
Let me ask.
Now then, it is my turn to ask questions. Whose master are you?
You!
Which tribe did you make your pact with? Answer me. Huh? What do you mean pact?
Burn in the fire! Answer me now. Pandemonium!
Though I shall cast you into a wavering grave. Watery grave, once you do. Did it specify don't answer?
Perhaps.
I think he's asking if you used to have a pet. Pet? No, the only animal I've taken care of was a hermit. Crap, we passed around in elementary school.
Impossible!
A mere insect?
Taste your
powerlessness! Your magic essence capped at a lonely 5, trash. Trash, really?
Meal!
Is it wrong to call trash trash? Trash like... You should not dare to speak to one as grand as me.
My name is Gundam Tanaka.
I am the great and powerful Gundam Tanaka. Supreme Overlord of Ice. Hold on a minute, something strange just came out of your scarf.
This is the Tanaka Empire!
Taming evil by using myself as a band. Truly, this is the secret art of the Tanaka Empire. It's like something you'd see in a nature show. I guess he totally fits the bill of Ultimate Breeder. One of my 4 dark devils of destruction. Mirage, Golden Hawk, Dumpy has this to say. We're not used to going easy on our enemies. so don't make us angry. You wouldn't like us when you were angry. You mean the hamsters are last? yeah, I know he seems a little odd, but apparently he did splendidly as a member of a breeding club. I've heard he can tame any animal, and if he managed to succeed at pro-life breeding an endangered species. Whoever has it, he could speak to animals. Well, that's probably just a joke. Speak with animals? Well, he's certainly eccentric enough on that regard. I mean, there's no way a normal person would attempt to raise hamsters inside their own scarf. Okay, I can exit. That's my pet gun.
Right.
Next to this place, we won't need to worry about food and other necessities for a while.
Wow.
It's just a figure of speech. But there's no guarantee anything here is edible. What if all this stuff is poison?
What?
You certainly are the skeptical type. Of course I am. Even this supermarket is strange. Look around, we're in this gigantic supermarket and there's nobody else here except us. Well, that can't be helped. Didn't you see me say this island is uninhabited? That's exactly my point.
What happened?
It's nothing. I don't mind you remembering it, but...
My name is Mikan Tsuniki. From the bottom of my heart, I hope we can get along.
It's okay if you take take your time and remember slowly. We'll wait as long as it takes. We'll wait for you forever if that's what it takes. Huh? See, he's just putting more pressure on there. Well, I guess I'll just ask you since I won't get anywhere asking her. So, what's her deal? Mikan is the ultimate nerd. If you ever get injured, you'll need her help. So it's best if you get along with her now. If you get wounded and don't treat it, there's a good possibility you'll get an infection and die. Let's say something so good, so naturally. So suddenly, it's just that I can't help it. I'm just so happy. I can't remember the last time I made any friends.
Sorry.
Now that you actually want to be friends with me, I'm so sorry. I said something so presumptuous. Just please don't hate me. Bullying a girl, not cool, Hajime. Seriously, why does this keep on happening?
I'm so sorry.
Check out this bomb stick, Moot Supermarket.
I see.
They got hamburger, ramen noodles, chili beans, bratwurst, pasta, melons.
No problemo!
Americans, Chinese, Mexicans, Germans, Italians, and even people from Yubari would stop here.
Yahoo!
Man, I'm getting heck yes stoked. I'm 31 flavors of stoked for all this deliciousness. And when I'm excited, I get hungry monkey. Hungry. I don't understand it myself. Why do I get hungry when I'm excited? Why do I get excited when I'm hungry? The human body sure is a mystery. This energetic young lady is known as the ultimate musician. She used to play guitar in an all-girl band. That was super popular with other high school girls. Apparently, their hit single, After School Pico Yo-Yo Hours, sold over a million copies. A super popular all-girls high school band? That sounds familiar.
What?
Due to creative differences, she left the band to pursue a solo career. Creative differences?
Oh my!
Are you interested? Wow, you can hear me? Duh, Ibuki's a magician, after all.
Guitar!
Like Cooper, Butch, Edison, Van Gogh, Harris, and, you know, I too am an awesome musician. Saying you have good hearing. Wait, most of those people you mentioned weren't musicians at all. Don't sweat the details.
Perhaps.
The Hotel Mirai, huh? It seems like it's named for the Japanese word for future. When we were told to live on this island, I was worried we'd have to pitch a tent or something.
I'm glad.
We can live in a grand hotel like this. I don't think we'll have to worry about being comfortable. Option here. We don't even know why we're being forced to live on this island. How can you just accept this? You're way too excited about living here.
Hey.
Well, it seems obvious that this area would make a good base, so why don't we look around for a bit? Why is this guy so calm? It's like he doesn't think the situation is a big deal at all. Has he been through a lot of trauma or something? Oh, the pet. It's a baby so far. Hold it right there, your voice is too soft. Let your voice raise from the bottom of your stomach. I'm Hajime Hinata. No, you could be louder than that. Do it again. My name is Hajime Hinata. Pleased to make your acquaintance.
I am Nekomaru Nida.
I'm Nekomaru Nida. Die. Don't forget it, even if you go to that place. I am the ultimate team manager, Nekomaru Nidai. You don't need to repeat your name so much. I won't forget it. I agree to your terms. Serious boisterous. It's not just his voice, his whole body seems loud.
Yep.
Nekomaru Nida is known as the ultimate team manager. The ultimate team manager? So he's not on the team, he just manages it?
Nope.
just a team manager. After all, he's an ultimate. He's traveled to numerous towns and played an active role in various sports clubs managing their teams. For instance, he led some high school rugby team full of delinquents to victory in the national playoffs. He also rescued a baseball club on the verge of being shut down and led them to national victory as well. Rumor has it he's even training that famous Japanese pitcher who plays in the American League. If that's all true, he totally deserves to be called the ultimate team manager, but... better off playing on a team instead of managing it. Oh, my bad. Friendly and stuff to me. Stupid. This guy is already in a bad mood.
You!
What are you looking at? You got something you want to say?
Now.
Relax, Yukiko. We're only here to introduce ourselves. What? Introduce yourselves?
Hey!
A bit properly introduced to each other, right?
Name's Fuyuhiko Kuzuryu. Just so we're clear, I don't plan to act friendly and shit with you guys.
We're getting used to when they actually talk. Even though he's got a baby face, he's also incredibly rude. Student heir to the Kuzuru clan. Yeah, the Kuzuru clan? Don't tell me.
Yep.
Sure, you've at least heard of them before, right? The Kuzuru clan is the largest criminal syndicate in the nation, with a membership of surpassing 30,000.
How admirable!
Yakuza clan, and it's the Kuzuru clan, no less.
Actually.
By the way, mentioning his baby face around him is expressly forbidden. So you better be careful. You'll run out of fingers before he's done with like you. That was close. I nearly lost all my fingers. Nagita, you're like my savior or something. You're just exaggerating. Guess not.
Hey, bastard!
Hey, we're all done here. How about you stupid heads make like a tree and leave? Hey, aren't you the guy who was squatting on the beach earlier and burying your face in your arms? Yeah.
You are a boy, right?
Hey, you gotta keep it together, you know? At times like this, it's the boys' jobs to keep the girls safe. You're right.
Yeah.
Did you want me to introduce myself? I haven't done it yet, right?
Let's see. I'm Mahiro Koizumi,
I'll be counting on you from now on.
Actually,
no wonder why she had a camera. Mahiro is known as the ultimate photographer. She has a promising future as a photojournalist. I'm not an expert in photography, but I hear she's a young photographer who has won numerous awards. On that note, she's known for her skill at taking pictures of people. The ultimate photographer, huh? Well, there is a camera you gave for her, Nick. I kind of assumed that already. Aww. Honestly, I'm a little relieved. You guys seem decent enough. Decent? Well, there's a lot of weirdos here. I can't tell if they're really ultimates or, like, just the same. I'm eager to get along with everyone, so we could get off this island, but I was worried things wouldn't go well. Get off this island? What do you mean? Huh? You don't know? That's what that stuffed animal Izumi was saying. After you finish collecting all the hope fragments that you earn by getting along with everyone, this joke of a school trip will be all over. And we can all leave this island together. That's all we have to do, and we could go home? Is that true? Did she really mean that?
Jeez!
Hey, you should be paying closer attention. This is, like, really important.
Hey!
Right? As long as we live here peacefully, we'll be able to leave this island soon enough. Sorry about that, guys. So there's no reason for you to act so panicky. Even so, what's the reason? Why do we have to do something like this? I mean, all the effort of bringing us here so we could all live together and get along. Doesn't make any sense.
What?
I may not know why we're here, but if that's all we have to do to go home, then that's all there is to it.
I'm glad.
Overall, I'm glad I mean, it's really not that big of a deal. Not a big deal, really? We're on a school trip without any warning, then we're taken to a place like this. But then we're told to forget about Hosepick Academy. Is he sure this isn't a big deal?
Hey!
Hey!
You...
Don't end me. What about your introduction? Like forever, you know? Oh, sorry. My name's Hajime Hinata. It's nice to meet you, too. I see. Hajime Hinata.
Too bad!
Sorry to disappoint you, but I've already made a mental note to remember you as unreliable Hajime.
You better do your best!
It's gonna be tough for you to change my mind. You better man up and try even harder to do your best. I see. You're whipped already, Hajime.
Got it!
Talking to both of you, you better man up and do better, got it?
Glad.
Yeah, even the inside of this place looks grand too. If this was really a normal school trip, I'd be smiling by now. But why are we the only ones in this hotel?
Now, now.
It's an uninhabited island. It can't be helped. For an uninhabited island, this hotel looks pretty well kept, and it seems electricity won't be an issue. What in the world is going on with this island?
State your business.
State your business. I want to introduce myself. Is that all right with you? An introduction?
Understood.
Understood. I don't know. I'm Hajime Inata. Nice to meet you.
My name is Peko Pekoyama. It is nice to meet you too.
This dignified looking woman is known as the ultimate swordswoman. It's hard to believe someone with a cute name like Peko Pekoyama could be so skilled with a blade. I've heard she's a kendo master that most adult men don't even stand a chance against her. But there's definitely something up with her. Her eyes are really intense.
It appears.
It said it's true. We are expected to live together on this island. Yeah, you're right. It is necessary for men and women to live together to respect each other. Don't try anything inappropriate. I would prefer not to kill anyone. Kill? Isn't that sword on your back made of bamboo?
Yes.
But it may seem impossible to kill someone with this. A misaimed blow can be fatal.
Well,
an aimed blow can be fatal too. It's Nanami. It's Yoki. It's just way easier to call her Shioki. I actually cosplay as her in the Comic Con. First cosplay, so it was just kind of like... There's some girl playing an arcade game, and she looks completely absorbed by it.
Hajime.
Hajime, you haven't properly introduced yourself to her either, right? Yeah, you're right. Really focused on the game, but I guess I should try to talk to her. Excuse me, I'd like to introduce myself.
Hey!
Hey, Shioki! Oh, sorry, I must have been a little too focused on my game. Hey, Little, are you sure about that? Let's see. Alright, introductions, got it.
I'm Chiaki Nanami, the ultimate gamer. Video games are my hobby, and I'm a fan of all genres.
Games. But yeah!
Nice to meet you.
Before I can start talking. Like, I can't talk that well unless I've already prepared everything I want to say in my head. Especially when I'm meeting new people. Well, if I get used to them, I could usually talk a little faster. She's still focused on the game and she hasn't looked at me at all. She may be the ultimate gamer, but how can she play video games at a time like this? I would be able to. Introducing ourselves first. Look, there are two people talking over there. Oh. Leading us. Especially in anime. Means something. Not gonna explain it. That's right. Time because it's full of poison. It really stinks. Speaking of which, it'd be great if you could use your mouth. To suck it out.
My name is Teru Hanamura. On the streets, I'm known as the ultimate cook.
Well, geez, I thought I got used to when they start talking, and here I am talking over their voices again.
But could you guys call me the ultimate chef instead? It has more of a big city flavor to it, you know?
Perverted speeches. introduce myself either. I am terribly sorry to keep you waiting.
My name is Sonya Nevermind.
Sonya Nevermind? I'm at the Nevermind part. It's just a little bit like... My name is Sonya. Oh, Nevermind. Your name would be Sonya to me. I am a foraging exchange student from a small European kingdom called Novoselica. I may cause trouble here and there, but I hope we can get along well. So same here, I hope we get along too. White porcelain skin, sparkly blue eyes, and your hair glitters like fields of wheat. It's like she has this mysterious charm that I want to gaze at forever. Are you enchanted? Well, that probably can't be helped. She's known as the Ultimate Princess, which means she's actual royalty. The Ultimate Princess? Normally I'd be surprised to hear that, but it's not just her beauty, she's just so grateful and graceful. Even though she's a real princess. This may be rude of me to say, but truthfully, I feel happy. Huh? What are you happy about? In my home country, I did not have a single friend my age whose standing in society matched my own. Something like this with everyone is a new experience for me.
I shall praise you.
I shall extol your virtues. Extol my virtues? Thanks. But I suddenly feel the urge to drop to one knee and bow. I'd like you to check out the restaurant first. It's the ultimate chef. Do you like it? I would be lying if I said I was interested.
Well, guess that's about
it. I like the big city flavor of my hometown. The country atmosphere like this is also splendid. Hey, are you?
Understand.
Fun, culture, guilty, SR. No, not that. You just don't seem very worried, huh? What's there to worry about? Actually, I'm really happy. Happy? Why is that? If I could get serious real quick, I have a sneaky suspicion that Miss Pekka is actually good at this week, if you catch my meaning. What do you think? What?
Bonjour.
This somewhere privately? I need something to bang my head on. Just kidding. Come on, come on. No thanks. Well, putting that aside for now, this might also seem unexpected to you, but I feel like Miss Sonia over there has a good chance of putting out. See, everyone knows princesses are groomed to lack common sense, right?
Understand.
For example, I could tell her. About poison earlier. Pardon me, what are you talking about? We'll discuss this later. I better not see you try that again. About stuff like that, I can't help but look forward to living on this island. When it comes to cooking and love, passion is the most important ingredient. This guy seems dangerous, but for a completely different reason. Pervy reason. Introduce myself to you.
Yep.
You don't need to worry about camping out if you're swimming in Silica. Right now. see how I'm lost, but like...
Hajime,
it looks like if we cross this bridge, we can reach another island not far from here. That's what we're going there to find out, right? If it's not safe, then when we get there, then what will you do? Okay, that was just a big, huge dirt mound.
Hey.
Ah, Byakuya. my first small introduction? Introduction? Come on, Hajime. Hello, my name is Hajime Hinata.
My name is Byakuya Togami.
Back off. I could tell this guy is thumping his nose at me. Well, I suppose that's Byakuya for you. What do you mean?
Actually,
that guy is particularly special, even by ultimate standards. He's next in line to inherit his family's massive financial conglomerate. Sorry. He's already begun managing the business operations and his net worth is, well, enormous.
How admirable!
It's completely accurate to call him the ultimate affluent prodigy. He is the etymology of excentric. You there, Hajime, was it? Eh? Tell me, why did Hope's Pick Academy choose you? What is your ultimate talent? The thing is, I honestly can't remember.
What?
You don't remember? Apparently he lost his memory due to shock. He can't really remember much. How foolish.
Yes.
I do believe we finished talking. How much longer do you intend to stand there?
Listen.
Move along. That's the only thing you skinny types are good at, it seems. Let's just leave, Hajime. Yeah, sure thing. This building, that overwhelming aura of refinement, just pushes people away. Is this what it means to be the ultimate affluent prodigy? Is that a school bell just now?
Huh?
Hajime, look at that monitor over there.
Congratulations, everyone! It appears that everyone has finished collecting the Hope Fragments. I'm so happy! So, I've prepared a present for everyone that'll make you all very happy. I apologize for the trouble, but please gather at the beach. May shining hope be with you all.
What to do?
I have a bad feeling about this.
But
thinking won't solve anything. We can do that after we go to the beach. Is that precaution really enough? To be honest, I'm really worried, but it would look bad if I was the only one who did it go. square meter. But if it was that line, something about pooping in that room. Don't tell me you're already pooping. Okay. So that's it for my part 2 of Danganronpa 2. You have me already like, comment, and subscribe. I forgot to mention this in the beginning. I'm Brion Liberator. Is signing out.